Hey, G12, welcome back to the episode of Is in Orbit. So today's episode, we got this cool image model here, and basically what this is a bed frame. You can see the one that we got right here is from a brand called Zinus or Zinus, and it calls it the Korey. So this is what the package looks like when you guys first get it. Let me actually open it up to show you guys what the inside looks like first. So basically inside the box, there's another box. Let's open up this as well. Alright, so this is basically what's included inside. So they do have like the middle part and a different like wooden part that should give you guys that foundation when you guys do set it up. Let's take everything out from the box and then start assembling it to show you guys how to do so. So in the very bottom, they do provide you guys instruction manual to teach you guys how to set it up and how to use it. And they also provide you guys all the different tools that you need to actually install it. So if you guys open up, first tool inside is the ratchet. Next one that we have is right here. So they provide you guys a bunch of screws and also the sets right here to actually screw it on. And then here is basically the instruction manual to teach you guys how to set up and how to install it. And then number everything so that way you know where to put everything as well. So we basically want to take out the metal parts first and then we're going to set up the wooden part on top afterward. So here is the first one we'll work with, which is number one and number two. So you can see right here on the side, they do label the number on here. So this is one and the other side is two. You can see right there. And then for this one that we got right here with the padding in the middle, this is the F1. So you don't want to install this one yet. This is for later on. So once we got one and two bar, now let's get number three and number four. So right here I got number two, three, and four. So you see how it's labeled two and three. So you guys gonna do two with two, which is on the bar right there in the floor. And the other one should be one and four, which is right here. And when you guys do open up the actual instruction manual, there's more detailed information right here. So you guys wanna open up all right here to actually screw it on both sides. So you probably need to use two on each side. So you basically want to just screw it in like this first. So now let's do the same thing for the other side. And we actually use the tool that they provide you guys to make your life so much easier. Alright, so that's good. And now let's work on the next step. So the next step is for you guys to set the headboard option, which is at the very bottom. So take that out. So here is basically what the headboard looks like. So even on the back of the headboard option right here, they do label the number on here, so that way it's no which side to put it on. But you basically want to screw it on this side and this side. So let's do that first. I basically want to put this on the floor so that way it won't get dirty. And you guys want to use the same screw to screw it on here, here, and the other side as well. So when you put on the screw, you don't want to make it tight just yet. You guys want to put it on and then tighten it up. Alright, so we're done with the headboard option. Now let's move on to the next step. So move this for now, because we don't need it yet. So next one that we work on is 5 and 6, which is right here. So this part right here is basically the back part, which is like this. So it'll be around like somewhere around here. And what you guys basically want to do is get the other bar with right here and insert it into this part right here. And the same thing for the other side. And when you guys do it, it is also numbered this side so that way you know which side to put it on. So 5 of 5 and 8 of 8. And also another way for us to know is by looking at the Velcro on top. If you can see the Velcro, it should be on top and not on bottom. So what we're going to do is screw this part onto the bottom part right here. And then you want to do the same thing for the other side, which is number 6 right here. But we'll do this first. So basically when you guys put in this part, you guys want to push it in. Just like that, in order for you guys to put the screws on. And same apply to this side when you guys set it up. You don't want to make it too tight yet until you guys put it on the other side. Alright, so that should be good. Now let's do the same thing for the other side as well. So you basically just want to insert into like this. Make sure it goes all the way in. Then you can put the screws in. Alright, so we got the screws on both sides. Now you just want to use a tool to actually make it tighter. We got that part done. Now let's do the same thing for the other side. Alright, so once you guys finish that part, then you guys want to get the M screw to screw it onto the back part right here. So let's do that. So the M screws are the longer one that we have right here. So there should be two on each side. Alright, so once you guys got that part done, you guys want to do the same thing for the other side. And I'll show you guys what the back part looks like in a second. Alright, so that's all set. Now you guys can work on the next part in the middle. But before I do that, let me show you guys what the back part looks like.
So this is basically what the back part looks like. So when you guys screw it in, this is basically for this bar right here, and this is for the other bar that we set up right here.
So when you guys set up the middle section right here, you guys need to use this small little bar right here for the foundation in the middle. So you see the hole in the middle? So you guys want to put this down like this. And then we do have the last bar, which is F bar. So you're going to put this in the middle. And when you guys put it on, you guys will make sure this part right here with the Velcro or this non-slip material is on top. But you basically just want to screw it on just like this on both sides. But before you guys do that, you guys want to screw it onto this bar right here first. And the screw that we'll be using is the L screw. Right to the middle. good. Now you put a screw at both sides. So you guys don't want to make it too tight yet. Just make sure it goes in on all four of them. Alright, and then the bottom part as well. Once you guys got it in, you guys are going to use a tool to tighten it up. Same thing for the bottom part. Alright, so once you guys finish that, then you put the wood on top. So the first thing I'm going to do is cut open the middle part so that we can spread it out. And when you guys look at the words on here, that is how you guys know which side is the front. So I need to turn this around to the other side. And once you guys do that, you guys want to spread it out. And you want to make sure the bottom part is sticking onto the Velcro, so that way it won't move. Got the top part done. Let's do the same thing for bottom part. Alright, so once you got it done, this is what the part looks like. So what I'm going to do is peel off the white part in the middle. And that is basically a sticky option, so that way you can put the mattress on top. And when you guys do put the mattress on top, it won't move around. So let's peel it out first. Alright, so once you guys do that, then you guys are basically all done, and now you can put the mattress on top. So the whole setup process and everything took me roughly around like 1 hour or 2 hours to fully assemble it. But you see, when you guys do fully assemble it, it definitely looks pretty nice. I love the way how they designed the headboard option, it looks so luxury and so modern. But now let's put the mattress to show you guys what she looks like. Alright, so once you put the mattress on top, you can see it definitely looks pretty nice. And it has a good foundation on here to support the whole entire queen mattress that we do have right here. If you guys care about the mattress that we got right here, it is from the brand called Sleep Innovation. But I definitely love the way how they designed the actual bed frame, because on the bottom of the actual bed frame, it does have the opening for you guys to put stuff inside if you guys want to. Let me actually move the camera to show you guys what I'm talking about. So I'm seeing the bottom right here is actually very spacious for you to put stuff inside if you guys want to. And if you guys want to put like a rug underneath it, you definitely can as well. So just to show you guys another point of view of what the product looks like, here is basically what it actually looks like from this point of view. And then here is the bottom. So it's definitely very spacious in the bottom for you to put a lot of stuff inside if you guys want to. But here is basically what the bed frame looks like when you guys do set it up.
So now that we did from boxing and testing of the bed frame, now to answer the question of whether or not it's worth it or not. So for this bed frame, I do have to say that it's pretty worth it if you guys want to need one of these, especially if you guys are trying to look for a high quality bed frame where it gives you guys everything that's on here, like the high quality luxury modern design look for the headboard option, and the middle frame in the bottom, and also like the bamboo wood or the wood in general in the bottom, then I do have to say that it's pretty worth it. But then obviously for those of you guys who don't want or don't need one or have one of these, then obviously don't buy one and save your money for something else actually you do need.
So that's basically everything for this video itself. If you guys like this video, make sure to smash that like button in the bottom. That will definitely help this video out. And it will definitely help with the algorithm as well to promote more videos for you guys, so you guys can see more of the videos or similar videos as well. But as always, make sure to stay positive, be you, and I'll see you guys in the next episode of Is It Worth It? Peace.